We're here in the beautiful Upper Peninsula of Michigan, and we wanted to bring you an update on how the sugar bush is coming together. We've had some delays in the actual construction of the sugar house, so we're not actually under the big time crunch of getting the Spartan 3000 taps in this fall and winter, but we did go ahead and start working on the sap house and where the sap is all going to be gathered and how we're going to demonstrate how we do that with a couple of different layouts. The first thing that we did is when we walked the entire sugar bush, we saw how the land was laying, and it was all running towards I Road. And there was one drainage in particular where it all flowed into. So it was the lowest spot in the woods, and that turned out to be right along the paved road that is I Road. So we identified this low spot, and Kyle went in with a backhoe, and we knew we needed about a 20 by 20 foot opening. And the only way we were gonna get low enough is if we went about 4 feet in the ground. So we dug that hole, and we had Bickler Concrete came in and they helped us on some prototype concrete. And this was a really unique pour. This was a self-leveling concrete, and we've already done a video on that. Really worked out well for us. It was easy to install. It had some really good PSI, so we know it's going to be able to handle the weight of the tanks. From there, we let it cure over the winter, and then this year we went in and we put in these large retaining wall concrete blocks. And the big ones are just shy of about 4,000 pounds. They interlock together, and they're about 2 feet tall for each block. And we laid two courses of those blocks up. So we have about 4 foot sidewall on the building. We had to, before we ever built the top of it, we had to install the tanks, and we did that with a backhoe and a couple of guys and got these tanks, and so they're tipping downhill. Everything is good to go there. Then we had to begin the construction of the walls, and we knew we had to have enough clearance when we were walking around in there and working in there that we decided to go with a standard 4 foot, what I call a knee wall, and we put that wall up. Started framing in and started to go from there. While we were doing that, we noticed that our current access to that side of the sugar bush was really limited. So we decided to make a new access out onto I Road. And so we got a hold of the county and let them, with the courtesy, we gave a courtesy call, let them know we were gonna put a new install out there. We put a culvert in, put down rock, had John Ryan bring us in some pit run gravel, which just really solidified the whole base. And it really made our turnaround and the driveway quite nice. And as the guys began to build out things, we went over again to Bickler's into their into kind of their area where they have the off color or cracked stairs. We picked up a set of stairs. They were kind enough to donate us a really nice set of stairs. So we got those concrete steps going down into our sap house. From there, you know, we wanted to represent Sparty and really have this be a showcase. So we went with our white sidewalls and we used a green roof. Now, we used that not only to represent MSU, but we strategically placed that green roof on there so it would melt the snow, keep the snow off of it. And if you've ever been in a sap house, they're almost always fairly dark. It's tough to see in there. So we used 2 feet right along the ridge. We used skylights up there, and that really lets in a ton of natural light. And it's also going to allow that building to ventilate. We didn't really close this building in tight. We're not going to insulate it. We wanted it to stay, cool during the spring so the sap didn't heat up in those tanks. We worked with UPCO, our power supplier, and we've installed a meter socket and a pedestal and a power wall. And they're going to bore the road underneath the road and drop us 200 amps. We really need quite a bit of power over at this site, mainly because our vacuum pump is going to be a variable speed, and we're going to have a phase converter on it to run a three-phase vacuum pump. So with that, We've pretty much completed the sap house a year in advance. It's going to allow us to put some temperature sensors in there so we know how it handles throughout the winter. There's some internal carpentry work that we need to do in the sap house. We are going to build a slight catwalk, so when you're working in and around and cleaning the tanks out, you won't have to utilize ladders or anything to get in the tanks. You'll be able to look down in them and have easy, safe access to it. It'll also keep it up off the floor, and so you won't track a lot of mud into the sap house. Again, everything we're doing is for research, it's for demonstration, and it needs to be a showpiece, and it will be a showpiece. So we're excited. We're a little bummed that the sugar house will not be completed for the 2021 syrup making season in the spring, in March and April. But, you know, we're looking ahead already to 2022. You will see several videos come out, so I would encourage you to like and to share, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. We will be putting up, as we complete our sugar bush, as we install the main lines and the lateral lines and the drop lines, you will see us, and we will bring you not only Facebook Live, but we will bring you YouTube videos throughout the entire process. So it continues. Have a safe and hopefully healthy, COVID-free fall and winter. Remember to wear your face mask. Stay 6 feet away from everybody that doesn't live under the same roof where you do. With that, if you have questions, please get a hold of us. We'd be happy to answer them. We might even create a YouTube video based on your questions. Thank you. Have a great day.